everyone, and welcome to a new episode on Front Row for Economy.lk. Today we're in conversation with Professor Nilanthi de Silva, who is the Director of Quality Assurance, the Quality Assurance Council of the UGCSE, and she's also a director at HEMAS. Welcome on the show. Lots to talk about. Higher education is a very diverse topic and has many nuances to it. But I think one of the key factors for the private sector has been in terms of the output and in terms of getting more industry ready students coming out. What kind of reform will really push that, and is something like choice part of this equation?
I think there are two aspects to this. One is that we need to increase the numbers that are coming out of our higher education system, and then we need to change the balance of the subjects that they are taking while they are in university. And in doing so, in both of those, we need to have close collaboration liaison with the employers of these graduates, the prospective employers, the stakeholders. So whether they are in terms of the, say, medical degree programs, the health ministry or private sector healthcare institutions, or in other, maybe in subject areas like management and commerce, they would tend to go much more into the private sector. We need to have that constant dialogue between the employers, prospective employers, regarding what they would like to see their graduates that they are going to employ, what competencies they should have. And then we need to work backwards in revising curricula, in developing new degree programs from the point where we identify those required competencies, and then what is the degree program that is going to build those competencies in the graduates. So,
sure. So that's kind of the role, that probably the link between the private sector and the public sector. In terms of getting things like the gross enrollment ratio up higher, and also I think enabling maybe a structural shift in terms of getting the student to decide what they would like to choose. Are those things on the agenda? Is it politically feasible as well?
Yes, I think the state has been trying desperately through the UGC to increase the number of students who are enrolled in the state universities under the UGC, but that's really not enough. We need to expand outside of the state universities as well. We need to expand higher education in the fields of technical education, for example. So those are institutions that come under the Technical and Vocational Education Commission. And we also need to make provision for students to go into the private sector higher education institutions as well. And that is where this concept that is being floated now, and what the task force for the chamber is putting forward, to switch from a situation where we have now of free education but with very limited choice to a situation where students have much bigger choice in where they go to for their education and carry their funding with them, rather than the funding going directly from the treasury to the university. We say that the student carries the student's funding to wherever they want to go to get their education. Yeah, so move from free without choice to choice with limited with better funding, self-funding.
Sure. And in this mode of expansion and moving also comes the issue of quality. And also with a lot of the private institutions coming up, quality is sort of a issue that's cropping up. I know that there's a new quality assurance bill out there, a lot of critics for and against it. And this has been a piece of legislation that has been in the pipeline for a long time as well. Maybe a bit about it, and how can we move forward in terms of getting to the ultimate goal of actually ensuring that there is a quality assured in the system.
So the quality assurance in higher education in the state system has been on the board since the turn, like, you know, the early 2000, that part of the time. But there hasn't really been any quality assurance activities nor accreditation in any form in this country up to now. Yeah, and no quality assurance in the private sector institutions, apart from some level of recognition by the Ministry of Higher Education through their Standing Committee on Accreditation and Quality. But that's not, you know, we need to have a commission that is independent commission, independent of the state sector, that is robust, that has people within the commission who have experience, knowledge, expertise in both higher education and quality assurance in higher education, to regulate this system in a much better fashion and ensure that when we expand the numbers of students in higher education, they actually get access to degree programs, programs of study that are of high quality, because that and accreditation system means that you have self-evaluation, inspection, site visit, review report, all of that, and it's done for a limited period of time. You say that accreditation is for 5 years or 7 years, and then once that period is up, you need to go through it again. If you don't meet the requirements, you will get provisional accreditation and conditional on meeting certain requirements. So that kind of independent commission, I think, will enable our higher education system to grow in a much stronger, much better way, position than we are right now.
So on that note of a stronger, better, quality assured education system, will draw this interview to a close. But I think we've had some interesting insights in terms of the concept of choice, in terms of the education system, how we can maybe reorient certain things to produce output that is future ready and also private sector ready in terms of the aspirations that are there that needs to be fulfilled, and also on the quality angle as well. Thank you, Professor Nilanthi. It's been a pleasure to interview you for Economy.lk. For our viewers, stay tuned for similar videos like this, where we interview eminent personalities discussing some of the difficult issues of the economy.